part 6 is number type measure criteria and sharing. So in DHIS2 table of options, there's a place to define number type that we will discuss, and also there's a place to define measure criteria that also we will discuss. You can share your tables. Now we'll be focusing on number type, measure criteria, and sharing of pivot table. Okay, now we have a very simple table. Okay, very simple table. Let me add a column total to this table. Shall we say change our org unit a bit, just for the purpose of, so let me exclude the type dimension. Okay, shall we make the font size again back to normal? Then you can see the entire table. So these are numbers. These are numbers. So you can see the total number row at the bottom. And numbers HIV test performed in each district, disaggregated by male and female in each cell. Looking at numbers doesn't give a very clear idea sometimes. So sometimes if you see those as a percentage, it would be better when it comes to comparing. So in DHIS2 table options, there's an option to change the number type. Now our number type is value. You can change this number type to a percentage. But when you are selecting the percentage, you have to decide whether to make the total to rows or columns. In my example here, the column total is the whole, so that I should select percentage of column. So I select percentage of column, update. Now you can see here in 2017, female and male, we have percentage of each district where they have done HIV test. In 2017 on female, we can sort this column, right? Very easy to understand and interpret. So FIS district has done the great proportion of the total, while the contribution of sweet district is very low. It's very low, right? Likewise, you can one option. You can convert your data to percentage and percentage to data. Here, right. So it is very simple. It is very simple. So that is all about changing the number type from value to percentage. It could be, now you have to select whether the percentage you are calculating for rows or columns. It's very simple. All right. Second part is measuring criteria. Measuring criteria. So for measuring criteria, let me little change my table. I'm just going to select last 6 months. Yes. All right. Let me change the table a bit. So let me change organization unit. Shall we select groups, the public group in Sedog district? Okay. Update. Right, and I need to exclude the age dimension and sex dimension and time dimension, okay, to make it very simple. Okay, so I have a set of data, a pivot table. So what I am going to use is to use measure criteria. Using the measure criteria, you can filter out data in a pivot table. You can filter out data if you think you want to just see for each month where they have done more than 1,000 tests, just imagine, and just forget about others. So it should be more than 1,000. Very simple. Update. So you can see only where they have recorded more than 1,000. The rest of the data are filtered out. Rest of the data filtered out. At the same time, you can put upper limit also, say less than 200, so 2000, sorry. So that means everything between 1000 and 2000 will be shown while others are filtered out, obviously. But on this table shows the values only between 1000 and 2000. Anything below 1000 and anything above 2000 are filtered out from the table. So in this manner, you can filter your data in ages. You can set either upper limit, either lower limit, or both. You can set a upper limit or lower limit or both. Using this combination, you can filter your data to a great extent, and then you can, by filtering this data, you can have a good idea of your data by making this pivot table more readable. Right. So due to the technical failure we experienced, so before moving to the next, let me explain about the number type again. So for that, shall I again go to the districts in training land? Now here, so this is about our first part, or the first thing we discussed at in part 6, number type. So we have a pivot table here. So we have numbers of HIV tests performed in each in training land. So that means this total means the total number of HIV tests performed in training land in the month of February 2020. So having values are good, but little difficult to understand or compare. So for that, another option is to convert these figures to percentages. So DHIS2 pivot tables allow you to convert your values directly to percentage. You can select either value or percentage. When you're selecting percentage, you have to decide what makes the whole, whether rows or columns. If the columns make the whole, then you have to select percentage of column. In my example, columns make the whole. So total is this. So this is the entire country total. So I want to select here percentage of column, selected, update. Now instead of having just numbers, you can see out of 100%, so these are the percentages reported by each district. By sorting, you can have a better idea. So by looking at this, so you can see the greatest contribution is from Fish district, recording 27.2 of whole test, while the least contribution from Seed district, which is only 1%. Right. So that is the first part. Then we discussed about measuring criteria, the measure criteria, and the final part is sharing favorite. So as any other metadata, you know about sharing settings, we discussed, you can share this pivot table. So to access sharing, go to favorite, then share. Usually a pivot table, once you created, has public access. That means anybody can edit and anybody can view. You can limit this public access to view. So then anybody can view, else you can totally cut down the public access by select, right. Then you can select to whom you are giving the access, to whom you are giving the access. So the groups, you can users or user groups. Let me select a user group, HIV, yeah. HIV access is a user group. So to do this, you have to group these users. Obviously you have to group these users before. So I'm selecting this group. Now I have group access to HIV access user groups. So if I show you another tab, shall we go to see users? I have user groups. So this is the HIV access user group. I have only one user in that group. I can include any number of users in this group. So this is the group I use to share this pivot table. So now HIV access group can view. I can again change, can edit and view. So then they can even edit. Apart from group access, I can give individual access. Say they are Aishas. I can share this with Nick. So I share this with Nick. Again, two stage of sharing is available. Can view or can edit and view. So likewise, you can enter any number of users. So with Pamod, okay. So I don't want to Pamod to edit this. So then I can just allow him to view this. So likewise, you can add any number of groups and any number of users to sharing. So mind you, even though you have added groups and users here, your preference here is override by public access. If you give the public access to everybody, whatever you have said and done here is overrided and public access is open. You can limit the public access. So that means public can view, anybody can view. HIV access group can edit and also Nick can edit. Likewise, you have to decide on the combination. This is how you are sharing your pivot table in the HIS2. Right. So this is the end of our part 6.